Hey, welcome back, everybody, to another episode of Ark Almost Vanilla. Well, we've had some interesting things happen since our last episode. I've got good news, bad news, and then more good news. First, we got Dixie and Normus over here. We went over to Herbivore Island, got him, picked him up with the RG, brought him over. They are here, and look at there. Dixie's actually got an egg for us. She must be pretty thankful. Whoops. That's not good. Let's pick this up. Go put it in our preserving bin. We've gotten a couple eggs now. Okay, so that's the good news. Or the first good news. So we got Dixie and Normus over here. Bad news is both Bandit and Batty died. We got into tangled. I got tangled up with some Allosauruses on the mountain there with Bandit. Bandit died to him. I took Batty out, and Batty actually tangled with those same Allosauruses, and he died too. This is our replacements. The 108 and 96 before their names is the levels that they were when I knocked them out. So we actually technically improved. We've got some better flyers than what we started with. Regrettable that the first two died, but we did improve. So bad news, that is also some good news that we were able to replace those. Another thing we did was we found ourselves a nice beaver. Here's Bucky. And we found ourselves a Anky. You can see that Bowser was only a level 76 when I got him. So he's not a real high level. Of course, you remember Marty. We got Marty in the last episode. I can start off by showing you guys what these two new gatherers do for us. Bucky here is a beaver. And like all beavers, he likes wood. And he does a pretty good job of gathering wood. So he got 76 wood off that one hit. He also gathers berries. So I'm not sure that I'm going to need to actually go out and get a specific berry gatherer. I'm probably going to start growing narco berries and croc plots. I mean, he does an alright job at gathering berries. The biggest thing I need to gather as far as berries go is gathering narco berries so that I can make more and more narcotics. It just takes a little longer with him than it would a trike or a stego or a bronto. But he does it. It just takes me a little bit longer using him than something else. So over that little bit of time we were working there, we got almost 1,000 wood. We got 124 thatch. And you can see the berries that he gathered. So he does an adequate job of gathering berries, but our main goal is there's wood for him. He gathers wood very efficiently. And he also has reduced wood weight. When he gathers wood, it's lighter in his inventory than it normally would be, so he can actually carry a lot more wood than a normal dinosaur could. He also, his saddle actually is a smithy. So if I had some materials and stuff in here, I could do things like fixing my pick. I could actually craft stuff in him or on his saddle because his saddle is a smithy. See, it's got the little anvil back there and stuff. And that's a unique thing about beavers. They're starting to do that with a couple more dinosaur saddles now. This is our Anky. Ankies are good at gathering metal. They gather like a pick. If they hit stone, they get more flint than they do stone. And they do gather some metal off the stone. But if we were to take him out and harvest metal nodes, he would gather a lot more metal off those metal nodes than I do. Let's get our gamma up here a little bit more, I think. So there we gathered 49 flint, 29 stone, and 1 metal off that rock. So he's primarily for metal. Now we could take him out to the base of the mountain. There are metal nodes and stuff out there, and we can utilize him to get metal from those metal nodes. As you can see, he also gathers. He also gathers berries. Not a bad berry gatherer, not a good berry gatherer either. Not like an actual berry gatherer. And if he hits wood, he gets more thatch than he does wood. So when I'm out here gathering stuff, I don't mind going ahead and hitting trees too, getting some thatch, getting some wood, getting berries on the way, and then I just go ahead and keep the berries that I want when I get back. So I haven't done much metal gathering with Bowser yet. I have done some wood gathering with Bucky, and some thatch gathering with Marty. But I still haven't gotten a Dodicarus yet. I haven't seen any decent level Dodicaruses around at all. Kind of holding off for a decent level. At one time I did see a Dodicarus in the 70s, but when I went back, there ended up being a level 100 Rex, and I do believe the 100 Rex killed the Dodic. It's unfortunate. We also did get one more tame. Nala here was a 112 Sabertooth. She was attacking our base, and I decided to go ahead and pick her up, throw her in the taming pen, and knock her out. Now, Sabertooths, they're good at gathering hide and chitin. That's a Pachyrhinoceros. There's a chance if we were to... They've got like a cloud ability that takes away... Right there. It's like a torpor effect. Slowed me down. I'm exhausted. I have no stamina right now. It takes all your stamina away. They're pretty good for PvP reasons. You take them into a group of people, use that ability, it takes all their stamina away and they can't get away. Use it by a bird, it can't fly away from you. So they do have some relatively good PvP aspects. Now, looking around our base here, our base is getting a little full after we now brought Nala and, Dixie Enormous back, and we now have Nala, and Drumstick was kind of our base protector, but I mean, between Bandit now and Bowser and now Nala, we pretty much have our base protected in other ways. Drumstick, he's kind of just taking up space here and eating up food. I'm not sure exactly what we should do with Drumstick. I think I'm gonna possibly put Drumstick to the test, and if he can prove his quality. Hey, Drumstick. Did you need jumping? Well, Drumstick, look around here, man. The base is pretty full. We got some pretty strong dinos around here that can kind of take care of base defense now, and I know you did a good job, but man, we're going to need to open up some space around here, bring some more dinos in. I'm going to have a test for you. Well, I know I can do it. I can do it. Well, we're going to see. If you can prove your quality, you can retire here at the base, and I'll keep you around. If not, I don't really have the space and food for you. Well, what do you want me to do? Well, I'm thinking if you can get me to the top of that mountain. See, I'd like to go collect some more crystal. And if you can get me to the top of that mountain right there and back, I'll let you live here for as long as you exist.
Well, I know I can do it. I can do it. I know I can. I'll get you there and back.
Well, all right. We're going to put you to the test. Just in case things quite don't go as planned, as things don't go as well as you think they were, I'm going to go ahead and leave my important stuff here, okay? Does that sound good with you?
Well, I don't think that you need to, but if you think that's necessary, you just do it, Master. I'll get you there, though.
Okay, let's get rid of this. Let's take some of this stuff off, because I just find it... I know you're confident and all, but Let's just leave this stuff here. Then it's time for you to take the gauntlet run, my man. So there is a path going up to the top of the mountain, around to the left over there. And I gotta tell you, there's some nasty stuff there.
Well, you know, I'm a terror bird, so I'm pretty tough.
Oh, all right then. I don't have much weight on me, so I'm not holding him up that way. There's already a saber tooth there. I guess we're gonna... Drumstick thinks he's got it in him. He thinks he can make it. We're gonna give him... We can give him every opportunity that he deserves. We're gonna go around here to the left. We've already passed up a couple. We got quite a bit of stamina here. He's a pretty good runner, to be honest with you. I gotta go around more. Drumstick, you better be quick here. You got a saber tooth right on your tail.
Okay, I'm going.
Let's go. Let's do this. Now, I've never actually... Oh, boy. Drumstick, you might live up to your name here. Yeah, I'm a little nervous for you, buddy. I gotta be honest with you. But you're getting along here pretty good. I'm pretty impressed how much stamina you've got. You can run for a long time. Oh my goodness. Now there is gonna be some nasties here at the top of the mountain. We're gonna have to be careful up here. Oh, a couple Ankies over there. I don't have my spyglass on me. Yeah, that doesn't matter. That's the mission, is to get to the top of the mountain. Oh, I forgot to bring my pick, buddy. Drumstick, I forgot to bring my pick.
Oh, master, does that mean I don't win?
Nope, Drumstick, you won. You did your job. No, actually, you still have to get back to base. Remember I said to the mountain and back?
Well, master, I got us here. I can get us back. I know I can.
Okay, Drumstick, let's take a break for a second here. Get our wits about us. You got all those saber-tooths and everything to run past again. They've probably all balled up together at this point, and I really hope you don't get trapped.
Master, I told you I'd get you back, and I'm gonna get you back. Here we go! Oh, Drumstick, what are you... I can fly!
Drumstick, you can fly. Look at you go. You're going to get us back, aren't you?
Yes, I am, sir. I'm going to get us back, master.
Oh, boy. Yep, I guess I forgot about the fact that these guys have a hover ability. And they can actually go for quite a long ways. You're almost there, Drumstick. You're almost there, buddy. You get to, boy, oh boy. I think we're just kind of lucky you didn't really have to do a whole lot of combat or no combat. But I didn't actually realize how much stamina you actually have. I was really surprised you were able to maintain that stamina long enough and run long enough that we got past everything. That's something I'm going to have to keep in mind in the future, and you might actually have some, use yet, to be honest with you.
Well, master, I told you I could do it!
Well, you made it, buddy, so, you know, you just stand there and you eat off that feeding trough as long as you need to, and when I build my next base, I'll bring you over to it, and you can just, hey, you can relax. You're pretty much retired because Nala's going to do most of the work that I was looking for you to do before, so you just relax and have some fun. Okay, well, looks like Drumstick proved his quality. He did his job. I forgot to take a pick with me so that we could get some crystal, but in all honesty, when I go up there to get crystal, I take Bandit up there, and we get a bunch of crystal and a bunch of metal, and we fly back down and cook it all up, which reminds me, I've got a bunch of, I should have a bunch of metal cooked up in here. I do. So we've done some metal gathering, we've done some stone. The one thing that's holding me up is gathering of stone. We do need to get a Dodic and Dodicarus for stone. Put all the metal in there for now. We'll transfer it over here because this is where we're going to be using most of that metal. I've got 3,000 stone, but you can see I've got 15,000 wood. I've got 8,000 thatch. I can very easily gather those materials now, but stone is still the thing that we need to worry about getting a gatherer for stone. Nala does a good job of gathering chitin. She does a good job of gathering hide and meat. Bucky here gets our wood. Marty gets our thatch. Bowser is our main metal gatherer. He also gathers flint and stone. Both Bucky and Bowser are berry gatherers. Dixie here is just laying eggs for us so that when we do find that Dodic, I might go get some crops from JoJo. She's got a crop farm. And I need some of those crops to turn those eggs, the eggs we have here, into kibble. Then when we knock that Dodic out, that's the kibble that they eat. It'll be a very quick tame. We'll get it done rather quickly. The thing about Dodics are they're pretty much exist. They spawn and exist in kind of nasty areas. There's going to be Sabertooths around, Rexes around, RGs around. We want to get that tame done quickly. So we're going to go ahead and maybe utilize some of her crops. Now, plans for today. I actually could get some stuff. I was going to get a greenhouse built where I could grow some crops myself. I was going to attach it to the back of the base here. Problem is I don't have fertilizer. And in order to make fertilizer, the easiest thing to do is to get we call them poop machines. And tame one up so we can feed it stem berries and have it poop out all kinds of poop. Because we need poop and thatch to make fertilizer. And it takes a little while, and I have to put it in compost bins in order for it to make. So let's go ahead and get some compost bins made. And then we're going to go get ourselves a poop machine. Because I need to get these crops going. Let's see here. We're going to need some wood. We're going to need some thatch. And some fiber. Go over here to crafting. Do I even know the compost bin yet? Yes, I do. S plus. Let's make 4 of them. And we're going to put them right inside the base here. Inventory. Well, I'm carrying all kinds of extra goods on me. Extra materials. I couldn't move. Let's go ahead and move Bandit 2 and Batty 2. Move them forward a little bit because I think I'm going to put the compost bins right back here. I'm going to leave that open. As a matter of fact, let's get that done. I have made some doors. Or I do believe a doorway. Yep, a doorway and a door. And when I build the greenhouse, it's going to be right out here. So let's put a door in right here. There we go. Now, right out there is where the greenhouse is going to be. So I'm going to put these compost bins right here. Well, let's go ahead and get into K mode here. Get the stuff. Oh, this reminds me. I got to get my armor and stuff back on. Let's go ahead and pull that a little closer to us. Right on. Oh, all right. We're pretty straight, too. Move over a little bit. Put that one down. Two. Three. And four. All right, then. Then we'll just put our poop machine right here. It'll put poop out. In here, we end up putting some thatch. And then six pieces of poop. And over time, it'll turn it into fertilizer. So, we need to go find... Well, let's get all our stuff back on. What am I doing? Drumstick, he did. I could have left all my stuff on. Here, I had no confidence in him. No confidence at all. And he just showed me, didn't he? Might have to get him a mate or something, too. When I get a base built, I will have a kind of a yard around it. And nice thing terror birds can do is they can be like, you can put them on wander and neutral. And they'll walk around your base or out in the fenced in area. And anything that does spawn inside, which doesn't happen often. You know, see, in situations like that too, where something comes up and it's attacking. Terror birds can do, especially when they're in a pack, they can do a lot of damage. So let's get rid of this raptor out here. We've got a guy out here deciding he wants to eat up our base. So 32. Yeah, I did have a situation while working off camera. I had a situation where I had a level 100 Rex sticking its head in our base like I busted in on the other video. I did not have any tranquilizers or anything at the time, and I tried to attack it and get it to chase me away from the base so that when the time came that I had tranks and everything, I could tame it, and it wouldn't stop. It kept attacking the base, so I had to kill it. A level 100 T-Rex would have been a nice addition to the tribe, but it wasn't to be. Put that there. This here. Fiomia. I was sitting there trying to think what the actual name of the poop machine dinosaur was. It's a Fiomia. So we need to go find a Fiomia. You can usually find them along the coast and stuff. Shouldn't be too hard to do. At other times they're referred to as pig moles. I don't know. As you read Reddit posts and stuff, they call them poop machines, they call them pig moles, but the technical name for them is a Fiomia. And here we've got a group of Allosauruses that may end up being an issue down there by the base. We got a 12. What's the alpha? Is a 76. Oh, I'm not excited about that, to be honest with you. The Allosauruses are a pain in the neck because when they get grouped up, being on a flyer and they get three of them around you and the one has the alpha bonus, as you saw the little flames on its back, he may not be getting an alpha bonus, right? Yeah, he still is. Not now. He got too far away from that third Allosaurus. Watch when that other Allosaurus comes close. He should catch back up to the group. You'll see the highest level one will get what's called an alpha bonus. There it goes. See the little flame showing up on its back now? When he hits you, when that one hits you, it does bleed damage and slows you. So you get stuck in there. They start hitting you and slowing you. They just keep hitting. And they trap you just like that one Ledicus or whatever the big fish were that destroyed our raft. The reason they were able to destroy me is because the one got stuck on me, or I got stuck on it. So that made it so that I couldn't get away. Watching other videos and stuff, there is those fish are just about as fast as a giraffe, but once they've hit you and you start driving away from them, I do believe you can stay enough away from them where you can't destroy, they can't get back to you and hit you again. That's not saying another one can't come up from below and actually get to you, but it's not like an automatic kill when one of those, and I know it's Ledicus, I can't say the whole name, I don't know exactly the whole name, but we're out looking for Fiomias, so let's get this done. I gotta watch my stamina. This RG doesn't feel real bad stamina wise. Of course, if you're going fast flying the whole time, you can see that we're just about out of stamina now, and this looks like a pretty safe spot to land. Get some stamina back. Go ahead and check out what we need to level up on him. I think let's give him a little more stamina. And we're going to use him to kill things, so let's go ahead and get our... Oh, fog. The fog in this game is crazy. There are mods you can add to the game to get rid of the fog. I didn't really want to mod this server that much, so I haven't done that. The fog does make it, in a way, sometimes, it definitely makes it harder. Like, you can't see the stuff that's nearby. So, in that essence, the one bad thing about the fog, it also affects underwater, which doesn't make any sense. If you're underwater when it gets foggy, it's foggy underwater too. And you already can't see very well underwater, and then when it adds fog to that, you really can't see well. So, that's kind of crazy. Doesn't make much sense. Yeah, I think they need to recode that, get that figured out. We're looking for Fiomias. I generally go ahead and cut away and come back, but I thought we'd find one by now. Well, it doesn't even matter to us what level it is. It can be a level 1, level 4. It's not going to be doing any fighting or anything. It's just going to sit there and poop. So, in that essence, the lower level, the better, to be honest with you. Okay, we're going to fly up along the... there is a swamp ahead of us here. This is the path JoJo brought us around the mainland, around the island. There's a Fiomia. Let's go ahead and land. Get our stamina back. There's a couple Fiomias here. One of them's getting attacked by a Titan Boa. Should I save that one's life? Titan Boa, Achatina. I think the Fiomia might be dead. But we got another one. There's another one right there. 32. Level 4. Hey, I think I like the level 4. That thing should be almost an instantaneous tame. You can come with me. Little level 4 female Fiomia. And it's orange spotted. Yep. She's got orange inside her ears. What's going to be the quickest way back to base? I wonder if it'd be safer just going... Yeah, let's just fly over top. There's our mountain over there. We're going to go right through here in the middle here. We get to see some new creatures. That's a Calicotherium. Level 36 and a 20. You have to tame those by passively taming them with beer. Yeah, beer. So what you do is you sneak up behind them, and you can use your E button, and there's a Quetzal. Quetzal is something that would be actually really handy right now, especially if we went looking for a Dodicarus. Because a Quetzal can pick those up, just like I picked up this Fiomia. They are just too armored and too heavy for a... That's a level 48 Quetzal. Too heavy for a RG to pick up and carry. Now, if we have to land for stamina here, which we will, we're going to have to drop this Fiomia. Hopefully it's not in an area where it's going to get attacked by anything. Let's go. Yeah, we got a ways we can go yet. We just don't want to feed this Fiomia to a Rex or anything, or Sabertooths or anything else. So we're going to find a safer spot maybe. And it's going to be walking around while we're trying to get our stamina back. It's going to be wandering around, and we'll just have to wait for our stamina and then pick it back up. I think we can get all the way back to base from this area right here. So let's go ahead and make this our spot. I see a couple pteranodons on the ground, so I'm thinking there are not any bad guys around. Because bad guys, they attack the pteranodons right away, and then the pteranodons, once they get hit, they take off and fly away. So if you see a bunch of them walking around on the ground, there's a pretty good chance there are no bad guys nearby, no aggressive carnivores. This side of the mountain, there's kind of some open area, and you can see some bad things. There's a couple Rexes right below us here. Everything's been, for the most part, lower level. Yeah, he wants us. He thinks what we're carrying is food. Yeah, I'm not feeding my Fiomia to you guys. I need him. So you guys just go find food elsewhere. There's a Procoptodon, which is a big kangaroo. You can get across the map really quickly on a Procoptodon. They don't serve a whole lot of other purpose. Now, you can actually carry somebody. You can ride the Procoptodon with two people. You can have one person in the pouch. That's right, a person in the pouch. And they can be shooting a gun or something, and another person rides the back of the Procoptodon and drives. So, I never really found the usefulness for that. Gallimimus is another one that has a multi-person saddle. You can have somebody get in front of the driver facing forward, and you can get somebody behind the driver facing backwards. Now, that one I actually kind of could get some use out of. If you're wanting to tame a T-Rex or something, you could have somebody driving a Gallimimus and somebody shooting from the back seat out toward the Rex and knocking it out. And a Gallimimus is definitely fast enough that a Rex would never catch it. So in that essence, that would be a decent multi-saddle dinosaur. Tapijara is the same way as the Gallimimus. It's got two rider seats besides the driver. There's a nice big Megalodon right up here next to our base. And that's something I'm kind of... That's why I'm going to have my base near this deeper water, so that my aquatic animals can be right up in and protected by my base. Well, see, this guy, I'm just going to go ahead and stay in here and knock this guy out. It shouldn't take much, and no, not yet. See, he won't attack me. He'll just keep trying to run away from me. Two shots and he's down. Let's go get some Mayho berries and some Narco berries. Now, it doesn't take very long to tame something like this up, so it's not going to take much in the far of Mayho berries or Narco berries, but with being such a low level, they also don't have much torpor. You see 275 torpor left. So it doesn't take long for that to just go away. Well, yeah, but it being a level 4, this is not going to take long. There we go. And this is, let's cancel. What do we got? I got a female. I think I know. Oops. There we go. Because she's got little orange dots. Let's see. Let's have her follow us. Yeah, look at that. I mean, they're not ugly. I like, yeah. Yeah. Pig mole. Let's go make her a saddle. Get her in the base. And we got a bunch of, well, she's going to try and follow us through here. Let's tell her to stop. You can stop. We also need to put her on passive. We need to learn how to make a Fiomia saddle. Using all these M-gram points on this stuff for a saddle that I'm only going to use one time. It's only 6 M-gram points, so it's not that bad. Let's get out of this. Back into crafting. Saddles, saddles, saddles. Fiomia saddle. A little bit of hide, fiber, and wood. There's some hide, wood, of course, fibers in the other one. Crafting, Fiomia saddle. Let's just put all this stuff back in here. Good. Taking a little bit, there we go. All right, Dottie, it's time for you to come into the base. Oh, nice. Big butt's right in my way. On here. We're just going to raise her health. Now, I think I'm stuck in the door. Oh, no, she's doing level up. They're not very fast. They can't. They do have an attack, but it doesn't do much. Here's fast speed. Okay, she just pooped. I don't even know if she can. No. She can't even collect berries. She really is just a poop machine. Her stamina's almost gone already. Alright, well, we're gonna just park you right over here. Now it's time to really show what you're for. Let's go get some... get these narco berries and stuff off her. Put them back in here. See what I mean about our base getting crowded now, though? But I guess Drumstick did what I asked him to do, so... He gets to hang out. He can retire now. He looks like he might be older. Look. He got some gray feathers and stuff in his head. I think he is an old... Nah, he's a wily old thing, isn't he? Yeah. Oh, poop. Let's take these. Oops. Now, that's one thing I will do, is I'm going to take the saddle off. So that I don't actually, when I do make that mistake, click on her. Let's put the saddle in her inventory. So, see, you go to pick up poop here, and you have to hit E to do it. Well, if the E is on her instead, it opens up her inventory or has you mount her. So, we're feeding her stem berries now. And you can see as I feed her stem berries, she's just pooping all over the place. It's poop everywhere. Whoa, oh, that might be enough. Just poop everywhere. Look, that's good, though. Because in this game, poop's a good thing. So, how many games do you know, or have you ever heard of playing with poop? Bet you can't think of one, can you? I can't think of any games I ever played where you definitely wanted poop or you dealt with poop. Let's see. Oh, she just pooped again right on me. Let me get this one. Got this one trapped over here by the wall. It was like a poop explosion. Okay. So let's get some thatch. Yeah, I'm still crouching. See, when you see me going real slow, it's because I'm crouching. And then I can also lay down. Mm-hmm. There we go. But we don't want to be doing that right now. So let's get up. Get ourselves some thatch. Yeah. 3,000 thatch. That should be enough. Let's separate this again. And again. I think I have 4 compost bins, right? So we'll separate this into 4. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And thatch. Now each of these compost bins would hold one more piece of poop, but so it uses poop in threes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I need 4 more poop here, Dottie. 1, 2, 3. And 4, I do believe. Did I get 4 out of that? No, I got 3. Oh, she just had a poop explosion there at the end. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Oh, actually, I was only on my 3rd trough, wasn't I? No? There's 6 in there. There's 6 in there. Okay, we are on our way to making fertilizer, people. And I think in the next episode, we're going to go ahead and put our greenhouse on there, and we're going to start making some crops. But I think our time limit's pretty much up, and I think it's time to call it a day. Drumstick proved his quality. He showed us that he could still do what he needs us to, or what we need him to do, so he gets to hang around and retire. Because Nala's going to do most of the hard work, and he gets to just relax. Look at there. All right. Well, thanks a lot, folks, for watching. Thanks for tuning back in. Hey, if you like what you saw, hit that like button. If you like what you saw, subscribe. Getting to be fun. We got to get a dough dick so we can start getting our new base made, the big base. We're going to have to start doing some stuff with JoJo, too. All right. Hey, well, thanks for coming, folks. And we'll see you next time.